now out of you. Well, I reckon that when this car number 9 gets down to the start control line, if you're sitting down, grip your seat. Otherwise, stand up and get ready to be entertained. Shane Van Gisbergen does not know any other way than flat out. No fear.
And he has the chance here to break a record. At the age of 20, he could become the youngest ever pole sitter, so he can only do it today because next year he'll be too old. Craig Lowndes was 21 in 1995. Van Gisbergen is just 20. And check out the burnouts down Conrod Straight. It's a drift comp.
He's put in some magnificent drives in the wet in recent memory, in particular at Sandown last year.
Craig Murphy with me, Murph. That really breaks your heart.
Oh, mate, I don't think it's going to be good enough to be too close to the front. I mean, the track's just going to get better and better, so that's the way it is when you have those conditions. But, yeah, bit of an error, and might be costly. You know, might be a few grid positions, which, you know, you want to be as close to the front as you can. So, yeah, disappointing.
Mate, you're extremely calm for this.
161 laps, mate. 161 laps.
All right, enjoy tomorrow, mate.
We do that for pole, you know. If you don't get on pole, then it's not so important.
Glad to hear you're philosophical, mate. Thanks.
Thanks, Bill. Cheers.
161 laps, you'll hear that a lot. The SP Tools, Irwin Entry, on track. He's won a lot of fans already in his very short career in V8 supercars. This is Shane Van Gisbergen. Todd Kelly holds the best time at 209.89. Van Gisbergen loves driving in the wet. Yesterday, in qualifying, he didn't really care what was in front of him. He was throwing this thing around. Will he be more controlled knowing it's a shootout? Will he be nervous having the track to himself? Or will he let it all hang out?
Yeah, Matty, the way he warmed his tyres up, mate, he hasn't had a good look at the wet conditions up here, so this is going to be very interesting to watch.
52.4 is the best time to the first sector. Only 2/100ths out. Here we go. Right out to the wall. It's loose, and McPhillamy, but he holds onto it.
It's because the rear tyre's got a coating of water. Just before he got to the maximum load point of that left-hander at McPhillamy, he hung onto it.
It's bumping and bouncing its way down the mountain.
For all the froth and bubble there, it's just slightly outside Todd Kelly's time at that first intermediate, coming up to the second one, but now he got the gain from the aggression over the top.
How do you like that? 1.2 seconds underneath.
That was a spooky moment at McPhillamy.
Well, it didn't rattle him too much, did it? And it's got some grunt through the chase. If he holds it together, this is going to be a very competitive time. Remember, Craig Lowndes is out next. The final turn, 6.213 kilometres. He has done it in 208.8. Stone Brothers Racing know they've got a talent on their hands. And now the battle is on. You want to watch this for total commitment.
It was up against the wall there on the run out of the cutting, and it's the next bit of racetrack where he pushed the margins. Watch this. That's McPhillamy, cracked sideways twice there. And prior to that, down in the hollow before it, he had it in the water and it just slid all the way along. So great car control. Here it is again. Look at this. And then he puts faith in the tyres at the hump at McPhillamy when they're wet. So he's gone in there and the boys, they know. They've seen enough of this to know what all that means.
Yeah, and Ross.